Hello.
Yes, long time no see. I know. I've been very bad. But I've just been experiencing the world instead of sitting in front of a camera talking about how I experience the world. But I'm gonna try and do more vlogs, more YouTube videos, because I'm actually helping my nephew with his. He wants to create a YouTube channel, and it's kind of made me realize that I actually have all these videos and I was neglecting this medium of communication and interaction with people who know me and people who don't, and ways to get my opinions across. And I feel like talking about it is the best way to do it. And today, what it is the season finale of Pretty Little Liars. Not just the season finale, it's the series finale. After what feels like 14 years, we will finally find out who A, AD, Uber A, Varjak is, and why they did what they did to these girls. I don't really have any hopes. I always try to keep my hopes low for anything. But I do have some hopes. I hope we get all four mums. I hope. That's really it, actually. I hope. That's it. Low stakes. But it's 2 hours, and if they. I wanted to go into it blind, but I accidentally watched the trailer. Without any sound, so it's kind of still a mystery, but still I know things like Mary Drake's gonna be in it. I knew Melissa was gonna be in it. So I'm like kinda leaning towards the, Melissa's. I've always had my suspicions about her. I care not for the ships at the end. I hope Spencer remains single. I wish a lot of the others remain single. Emily and Allison, fine. I have nothing against Emerson. Like, okay, so let's get into it. The fact that this last episode ended and next week we pick up a year later, they are going to have had a baby who they do not know who the father is. Like, I'm expecting this plot to be, okay, this baby needs a bone marrow transplant, and then like, oh well, I guess now, since our baby is ill, we should find out who the father is. Because how, why would you not want to know? Allison was raped, essentially. Unequivocally, that is the truth. She was date raped, not even date raped. It wasn't a date, it's sedate raped. Too much use of the word rape. But it was. She did not want a baby. And it isn't hers, it's Emily's. And some strange man. Or possibly not. Because my theory is it's Charlotte's sperm from before her transition. And that way it kind of brings it full circle, does it? Yeah, because it kind of makes it part De Laurentiis, part Fields. Either that or it's Jason's DNA, which is really creepy. Don't think that will make for a healthy baby. Whose DNA is it? Okay, so that's one question I want answered. The second question, I don't really care at this point who AD is. There's a clip of Mona in the trailer looking up, going, "I always knew it." No, she either says, "I always knew it would be you," or, "I never would have guessed it was you." I can't remember which she says. I'm really scared that they're gonna kill Mona off. I really want a happy ending for her. kind of sucked. The end of the last episode was really depressing, that, you know, all she wanted to be, all from the very, very beginning, she just wanted to be Hannah's friend, and it sent her insane. And she, like, just, Hannah, this girl wants to be your friend so bad, it drives her crazy. And then you have Aria, who could want nothing less than to be your friend. Choices. That's all I'm going to say. Choices. And I'm one of those people who kind of wants a happy ending for Jenna. Because she was like, okay. Since we brought it up already, yes, she raped her brother. But, stepbrother, but still, rape. Can't say that word enough. Incest, rape. But I'm one of those people who kind of wants Jenna to have a happy ending because she was blinded. And Allison never really paid for what she did. She never even come clean and said, yes, I was the one who blinded Jenna. So here's kind of my theory. Let me try and be concise about this because it can get confusing. Okay, so the way logistically I understand it is that after the Mona reveal in season 2, Marlene, King made plans for the next heir, and that was going to be season 3. However, during season 3, they got picked up for season 4, so that is when Marlene came up with the CC Charlotte idea. Supposedly. And I tend to believe that, because it makes sense, because then in season 4 they got picked up for season 5, and yeah, that was it. And so then they had to bring in Shauna to and kind of Ezra to just kind of throw off the scent, because they couldn't reveal Charlotte too soon. And then they were going to do it in season 5, but then they got picked up for season 6 and 7. So then they put it off again. And what we are seeing now in season 7 is the resolution of a plot that was started in season 3. And so back in season 3, they were still talking about the NAT Club. And a lot of true fans, diehard fans, theory spinning fans have been angry that the NAT Club was kind of never explained, and I hope I can theorize how they might explain it. Somebody was paying Jason and Ian to make videos of the girls. That somebody could still be Uber A. They wanted to find out about the girls and kind of mirror them. And how would they mirror them? They would create their own friends. And this is where how we can explain Sarah Harvey, because we still haven't got any explanation about Sarah Harvey. You know, why was she integral? But this kind of would make sense. So the Uber A, who in my theory is Spencer's twin, Mary Drake's secret second child, who was given birth after Spencer and hidden away by, if I really go deep into it, I was going to say like somebody who worked at Bradley, Elam, because there was that silence of Elam and we never found out what happened to him. What if he was going to come clean and say, you know, I bungled the second baby away, and A got to him before he could tell it. And that's obviously a crazy theory, because I don't think they'll do that. But something along those lines of, there is a Spencer twin, and she found out about Spencer and, you know, saw that, like, she had such a better life than her, so She, even though somehow this Spencer twin has money to pay Jason and Ian and the NAT Club to make videos, so that she can study the girls, study Spencer, start learning her mannerisms, and maybe even her plan was to kill Spencer and take her place. But whatever, she was there that night. That of which I'm certain there were two Spencers that night, because one of them was seen by Jason, but by an inebriated Jason. One of them was seen talking to Cece. And so Cece knows Spencer's twin, and this is a secret she's taken to her grave. And I think this is a secret possibly Sarah Harvey's taken to her grave. I don't know why. I don't know the why, I just know the how. I think that's my theory on how it was done. And Ren is in on it because I feel like Ren has something to do with Bethany Young. Because Ren is there from season one and he came into it to kind of spy on the Hastings and relay information back to the twin. I kind of have lots of hopes, and I didn't realize it until I got them all out, and now that I have, I'm kind of upset that I know it won't live up to the expectations that I have. But either way, what I have to focus on is that the show brought me in contact with a lot of great people, and will continue to have these friendships after the show has ended, whatever happens. And for that, I'm grateful. So whatever happens next week, I'm gonna be happy. And I'll see you again, maybe giving you even more thoughts on how I feel about how it all unfolded.